ropeways have been existing for more than 100 years, and our company has been designing, manufacturing, and installing these systems in many places throughout the world. Ski resort operators, any kind of touristic access to a mountain, we would deliver and we would install. More than 12 years ago, a customer contacted us with a special request. It was an urban transport organization in South America, Metro of Medellin. But the project was too small, was too easy, and I said to him, I'm sorry, you don't need one of our products or one of our systems because it would not fit your needs. So he came back 2 months later with a new project where really he was overflying a river, going uphill, going through one of these South American favelas, yeah, really using all the capacities of the system. And then we started working with him and they really believed in it, maybe even more than we did at that time. Less than 2 years later, the system was in operation. The municipality was completely convinced about the use of it. And we really noticed that we were completely fulfilling the needs of what urban transportation is expecting.
Transportprobleme haben, die nicht diese Dichte an Verkehrssystemen, wie wir in Mitteleuropa haben, dort die Verkehrsproblematik in der Stadt zu lösen, ohne sehr viel Geld in die Hand zu nehmen, ist sicherlich das Feld, wo die Seilbahn künftig sehr viele neue Plätze auch erschließen wird.
Istanbul oder Manizales oder Bogota oder wo auch immer. Die Städte sind auf Hiegel, brutal steile Straßen, noch haben sie alles Klonbusse und du mit dem Bus. Keine Ahnung, eine Stunde vor muss, bist du mit der Rundung in 10 Minuten dort.
Cities in South America have areas where it's already too difficult to build a conventional urban transport system. Therefore, they had to think differently. So Rio, for example, was okay with cables because they have a famous ropeway, which James Bond survived to go up to the Sugarloaf. And therefore it was relatively easy for them to install 6-7 lines of ropeways in an area which had no public infrastructure of any kind. They had a bit of electricity, but no water and obviously no transport. After, I think 14 months was the project, have now 6 lines of urban transport system flying over their houses and linking all these areas to the city of Rio, and it has brought a lot of advantage to this underdeveloped area.
Natürlich ein riesen Vorteil ist von der Seilbahn, dass sie in einem vorhandenen Verkehrsraum die dritte Dimension erschließen kann. Das heißt, dort wo ich schon eine Überfüllung habe, habe ich die Möglichkeit auszuweichen in die Luft.
Wenn man denkt, der Metro zu bauen dauert 10 Jahre und kostet ein Hundertfaches von einer Umlage. Nicht? Die Umlage ist im Verhältnis schnell gebaut, in einem Jahr ist eigentlich alles erledigt.
Sistemi di trasporto a fune hanno una portata oraria che può variare tra le 2.000 e le 5.000 persone ora, quindi una portata importante che però non va in competizione con altri sistemi di trasporto più tradizionali come metropolitane ad alta portata che possono raggiungere anche 30-40.000 persone ora. Un altro aspetto molto importante poi è anche l'aspetto ecologico. Gli impianti a fune hanno un unico motore elettrico, quindi riesco a spostare 3.000 persone all'ora senza avere emissioni nocive.
Die Linienführung in der Stadt ist natürlich sehr spannend, weil einfach diese Schneise, die wir gewohnt sind zu haben, die gibt es in der Stadt nicht.
Eine riesengroße Herausforderung ist, das Saal von der Station zur anderen Station zu bringen, weil wir fahren ja über heiße drüber. Meistens sind die Hausbesitzer ja nicht ganz glücklich über das, dass man ihnen eine Stütze vors Haus stellt. Nicht? Deswegen werden die ja sicher nicht bereit sein, dass man aufs Dachau geht, dass man das Soll rüberbringt. Nicht?
Of course, people see them more than when it's an underground metro. People are less used than when it's a new bus line. So you have to do a lot more convincing work. We have to make this very visible system, maybe an iconic system.
Gli impianti a fune in ambito urbano sono ancora sottovalutati. Per l'investimento basso, per i tempi di realizzazione, contenuti, per le portate che riescono a garantire per gli aspetti ecologici, per cui sono una soluzione. E va cambiato forse l'impostazione, va cambiato l'idea che la funivia si può vedere soltanto in montagna.
I've had situations after talking for 20 minutes between the airport and the place where we were building the extension of system, the taxi driver said, no, don't pay, because what you are doing for our city is just wonderful, because we have this. And I was saying, you're paying us for that. And he said, I had this sort of experience, and that's really funny. We really believe we have lots of potential solutions to bring. We will never do everything in a city, but we'd like to have people enjoy and use the solutions here. Yeah.